Prepare IAS coaching. It is one of the best coaching institutes for IAS and PCS preparation in Lucknow. This is the address and this is the contact number. You can contact them for getting further guidance for your preparation. So, hello everyone. In this video, we'll do the daily current affairs analysis of 18th October 2021. So, the first topic which we will discuss is what is the impact of COVID-19 on TB elimination efforts? So it is from GS paper 2 and topic is government policies related to health. So why it is in the news? The global TB report is released by the World Health Organization, WHO. Key results: the world is facing a major shift in the eradication of tuberculosis TB by 2020 thanks to the novel coronavirus COVID-19. A major impact was felt in relation to the discovery of new cases. This means that a large number of cases have went away undetected due to reduced access to diagnosis and restrictions to contain the epidemic. So as you have seen that a lot of countries have imposed strict lockdowns and which has restricted the movement of people. There were instances in India also where only people or agencies associated with the goods of significant importance that were allowed to ply on the roads, and all the normal citizens were not allowed to even go out on the roads. And when this happens, so the diagnosis of the diseases, other type of diseases, automatically reduces, because in TB what are the symptoms? They are basically that a person suffers from like a cough or like lung infection, symptoms of that, coughing, breathing issues. And if some person is having that, and if he or she is not able to diagnose that properly, so automatically the number of detected cases, the number of cases which are registered for TB, for example, will automatically go down. So that is the effect of COVID-19 on other type of diseases. Their detection and subsequent diagnosis and their subsequent treatment and the well-being of the individuals suffering from other type of diseases has suffered because of COVID. Okay, so it is a side effect or a negative consequence of the lockdown and restrictions imposed to contain the COVID epidemic, you can say that. Okay, so from 2016 to 2019, the number of new cases increased steadily but dropped sharply to 20% by 2020. The sharp decline in the number of reported cases of TB in 2020 compared to 2019 means that the gap between the number of people diagnosed with the disease and the number of young people diagnosed with the virus has widened by 2020. The report estimated that the gap was 4.1 million cases, around 41 lakh cases. Okay, so India has also faced the issue of a large number of new cases. About 41% of the total number of cases dropped in 2020 compared to 2019 came from India. As a result, large number of TB cases disappeared from the country. A dramatic decrease in the number of cases of the TB has resulted in an increase in the TB deaths. TB is ranked 13th in the world or in the number of deaths worldwide until 2019. So due to major issues, it is now considered to be the second leading cause only after COVID-19. The key steps in the end TB strategy in India to reduce the burden of TB diseases by 2020 have led to a 35% reduction in the number of TB deaths in India. So what is TB basically? So the TB is an infection caused by Bacillus mycobacterium tuberculosis. So it can be a potential statement in prelims. It usually affects the lungs, TB of the lungs, but can also affect other sites. This can also be a potential statement in prelims where UPSC can give a statement that tuberculosis affects only the lungs. Okay, so in that case, that statement would be wrong, because TB affects other areas as well, but the majority of people, they suffer from TB of the lungs. Okay, so the disease is spread when people with lungs expel germs from the air, for example by coughing. Okay, so India's efforts in this regard, India is aggressively implementing its national TB strategy. In the last few years, 50 million people have been treated. So around 5 crore people suffering from TB have been treated in the last few years in India. Okay. So India seeks to achieve global expansion of TB prevention, TPT, treatment. It also aims to achieve the goals of the UN high-level meeting, UNHLM, for the 40 million people who have started TB treatment and the 30 million people on TPT, TB prevention treatment worldwide in the remaining 18 months. Sub-national certification of states and regions established in 2020, the campaign marks the UTs or countries in progress to be TB-free state under the various categories measured with the prescribed rates of TB incidence. So prelims hot link topics are SDG in reducing TB, what is NTEP and its purpose, about the Central TB Division of the Government of India, annual TB report is released by what is TB and how is it caused. The source of this news is this article from Times of India. You can read that. So next is about the COP26 climate conference. It is from GS paper 3 and topic is conservation related issues. So why it is in news? The UK will host the COP26 UN climate change conference from October 31, 2021 to November 12, 2021. This year marks the 26th party conference, hence the name COP26, and will be held at the Scottish Event Centre in Glasgow. What is a COP conference? So the COP is related to the United Nations Climate Change Framework Convention, UNFCCC, established in 1994. The UNFCCC was established to work to reduce the impact of the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. COP members have been meeting annually since 1995. COP1 was held in 1995 in Berlin. So why these countries, why all the developing and developed countries, all of them, why they are stressing a lot on reducing the impact of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere? Because as the amount or level of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere increases, or the majority of which is contributed by carbon dioxide, so what it does, it automatically raises the temperature of the earth, of both the of all the surroundings, like the land area of the earth, the sea surface of the earth, and also the temperature of the air of the earth. All these are increased, and as a result, the melting of glaciers, that is the speed of melting of glaciers, that is done at a faster rate, and that also affects the permafrost regions. Okay, the permafrost are thwarted at a very significant rate when the greenhouse gas levels increase in the earth, and as a result, in the short run, when the glaciers melt at a faster rate, what it leads to, it leads to more instances of floods, and affecting the people in the, which affects the people in the coastal areas, their lifestyle, economy, everything is affected, and also the waterborne diseases, they happen at a faster rate. This also affects the food and energy security, the infrastructure in the coastal regions, and the floodplain regions where the rivers pass through. When a flood comes, so the whole infrastructure, be it the social infrastructure, like the health, education, water, sanitation, housing, all those, also the digital infrastructure, financial infrastructure, railways, roads, everything, and also the human infrastructure, because when a flood strikes, loss of human lives is also there. So everything gets affected in the short run, and in the long run, when the melting of glaciers is being done at a faster rate, so in the long run, the instances or the chances of drying up of rivers or the changing of the river courses, that is very high, and which automatically leads to higher instances of soil erosion, because once the rivers are dried up, so the soil loses its capacity to hold the the roots of the trees together, and as a result, whenever there is a land slide or any such event, tsunami or any such event in that area, so the instances of avalanches, landslides, and soil erosion, that automatically increases, and as a result, the instances of loss to human capital and social capital, that also increases, in the future. Ultimately, that leads to having a negative impact on the economy of that region. So this is all, this is interlinked. That is why a lot of stress is being given on reducing the menace of climate change, because the impact of climate change cannot be nullified. Okay, it cannot be done to zero, it cannot be reduced to zero, but the impact can be reduced by deploying more renewable and renewable measures and sustainable measures, like the usage of renewable energy or reducing the usage of plastic, like instances like that. Okay, so that is why countries are focusing a lot on climate change. Okay, so it lists what the COP does. It lists the obligations of the member states, including measures that are being developed to reduce climate change, collaboration in preparing for adaptation to the impact of climate change, promoting education, training and public awareness about the climate change. Because government, what it can do, it can only bring out the policies, but that implementation of those policies at the ground level is in the hands of the general public only. So that is why using proper IEC measures, information and information education communication measures, to educate the public, to create awareness among the public, general public, regarding climate change, regarding the negative consequences of climate change for the future generations of those general citizens, is very important. Okay, so that is one of the obligations of this COP. So according to the UNFCCC, COP26 will work to achieve four goals: protect global net zero targets in the middle of the country and keep 1.5 degrees accessible, synchronize protecting communities and natural areas, fundraising to achieve our first two goals. Developed countries must do well in their promise to raise at least $100 billion in revenue by 2020. Complete the Paris rulebook. Leaders will work together to draft detailed rules that will help implement the Paris Agreement. What could India do to achieve its goals? It is time for India to renew its national contributions, or INDCs, intended nationally determined contributions. The NDC describes in detail the various efforts taken by each country to reduce national emissions. Multi-sectoral strategies are needed to bring about development, because climate change is not the responsibility of the Ministry of Environment alone. Because all the other ministries, they contribute to damaging the environment in some extent. So that is why it is very important that all the various ministries work together to reduce the menace of the climate change. That in that way only the contribution of India as a country to reduce the impact of climate change can be seen at the global level. Okay, so we need to reduce the usage of electricity in various sectors, including the electricity sector itself, the transport sector, and start looking for carbon free initiatives for each passenger. It is also very important to find out how we can transform our coal industry, like the usage of non-thermal power plants to generate electricity, like the usage of wind energy to generate electricity in particularly coastal areas like Gujarat, Rajasthan, or the southern states of Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka. That is very important. Okay, so the time may have come for India to announce that we will no longer build coal-fired power stations beyond what is on the line. Like the existing ones can remain, but them also, you know, need to be made more efficient and more productive. The climate, the impact on climate due to the generation of waste from these power plants need to be rationalized. Okay, so India also needs to strengthen the legal and institutional framework for climate change. So source of this news is the Indian Express article. You can read that. So next is about the Global Hunger Index. It is from GS Paper 1 and GS Paper 2. Topic is poverty related issues. So why it is in the news? It is issued by the Global Hunger Index 2021. India's performance. India has lowered 7 places to 101 out of 116 countries. The level of hunger in India was critical, according to the report. It is ranked 4th in the South Asian countries. Only 15 other countries are listed under India in the index. Bangladesh 76, Nepal 76, and Pakistan 92 fared better than India in the race. By 2020, India is ranked 94th out of 107 countries in the index. India points in the index over the past two decades have declined by 10 points. Globally, India is ranked among the worst in child abuse or high weight. In its performance was worse than Djibouti and Somalia. What is the Global Index for Hunger? The Global Hunger Index, GHI, is published annually as part of a partnership between Concern Worldwide, the largest aid in Ireland, and World Hunger Help. The first GHI report was published in 2006. GHI is intended to be a tool designed to measure and monitor poverty at the global, regional, and national levels. How are countries calculated? Four indicators were considered in calculating the world point out of 100 in order to determine the standard: malnutrition, childhood malnutrition, percentage of children under the age of 5 with low birth weight indicating severe malnutrition, child disability, percentage of children under the age of 5 with low birth weight indicating chronic malnutrition, child mortality, mortality rate of children under 5 years of age, a three-step process based on scoring points for each indicator and its aggregation produces a national GHI score at 100, GHI severity scale, of which 0 is the best and 100 is the worst. Things that made the situation worse: climate change and the coronavirus have exacerbated global food insecurity, including in India. However, why has India opposed against its position of the 2020 Global Hunger Index? India has come out strongly against the Global Hunger Index publishers for years with questions of trends and data sources during the global downturn from 94 in 2020 to 101 in 2021. The Global Hunger Report 2021 reduced India's status on the basis of FAO estimates, calling the FAO method, what is FAO? Food and Agricultural Organization, which is under the aegis of the United Nations. So calling the FAO method as unscientific, India has stated that the scientific measure of malnutrition will require a measure of weight and height, and the method involved here is based on a Gallup survey based on pure human self-measurement. Also, India said the report does not take into account the government's major efforts to ensure food security for all people during the COVID, taking into account the verified information available. So prelims hot link topics are all about the Global Hunger Index, because in recent years UPSC has given questions from both in prelims and in mains from the topics which have been in controversy. Okay, so that is why you have to focus a lot on this topic. And references about this: levels of hunger in India, the performance of India in this index. Source of this news is this article from the Indian Express. You can read that. So next is about the China's hypersonic glide vehicle test. It is from GS Paper 3 and topic is space related issues. So why it is in news? China in August 2021 tested a nuclear powered vehicle capable of using a hypersonic glide that orbited the Earth before speeding towards its target. What is hypersonic speed? Hypersonic speeds are 5 times or more than the speed of sound. Concerns and impacts on India and the world: the weapon, in a sense, can fly over the South Pole. That could be a major challenge for the US troops because their missile defense systems are focused on the northern polar line. India is deeply concerned about the recent developments that have led to declining relations with China in the past. Such initiatives exacerbate the threat on our space assets as well. Technology used: the exact details of the technology used by China in this particular test are not known to the media, but most vehicles who have used this technology in the past have used the scramjet technology. So what is scramjet technology? Scramjets are a type of engines designed to control the speed of airflow in multiples of the sound speed. In a scramjet engine, air from the atmosphere is blown into the engine fire chamber at the speed of more than 200 on the Mach. In the chamber, this air gets mixed with gasoline to heat the fire energy. but the cruiser will be at the hypersonic speed of Mach 6 to 7. So it is called supersonic combustion ramjet or scramjet. So prelim shortlink topics are: who founded the HSTDV? Which countries have successfully tested hypersonic technology to date? What is a scramjet? What are ICBMs? How many countries have ICBMs? So next is what are the bow arrows and what are the ballistic arrows? We have to study out that. The source of this news is this article from Indian Express. You can read that to get better understanding about the topic. So next is, what is Henrietta Lacks? Who is Henrietta Lacks? Okay, so it is from prelims. It is a prelims specific topic. So Henrietta Lacks, an African American woman who died 70 years ago because of cervical cancer, was awarded post-mortem by the World Health Organization (WHO) on October 13, 2021. Her biopsy samples, collected without her consent or understanding, made untold successes in medical science and assisted in research on the novel coronavirus COVID-19, the cell line, which is the first immortal line of human cells permanently separated from the laboratory, was crucial to the development of the human papillomavirus HPV vaccine, polio vaccine, antiretroviral drugs, and cancer. Called HeLa cells, Lacks cells are also important in the study of Parkinson's disease, reproductive health, including in vitro fertilization, chromosomal conditions, genetic mapping, and precision medications. The source of this news is this article from the Bristol website. You can read that to understand better about this particular topic. So thanks a lot for watching the analysis video. Have a nice day.